streams.
Louder. On this side, but yeah, so I got it all unloaded. My JB Weld cracked on my headlight because I was lifting it up to get the bumper squished under there, so I had to give it another little zip tie, some more zip ties, and then it's zip tied, and then it's zip tied. And if you come over here, zip tied. I got some zip ties, a little zip tie right there. Yeah, I used to not have that many zip ties on here, but yeah, look at that. Oh. Tighten up the zip tie, but yeah, so we got the premium looking thing, the nice little wreckness of it, you know, it's got some nostalgia, you know, into it or some shit, I don't know.
What are you doing, Trev?
You're making me a sandwich, dude.
Sandwich?
Yeah, I was hunting around Walmart this morning, and I was like, shit, I don't want a peanut butter and jelly, because that's going to be cheap, because we're going to be here for 2 days, and there's no food. What so kind? I got a $2 bread and a $2.50 thing, and I'm going to eat, well, feed you and me for the whole weekend for $5.
Good.
Look at that. That's my goober sandwich. Ask Jesse.
Oh, hey, bud. What's going on? What do you got going on right there? Uh-oh. What's going on right there? Is it that time of the month?
Yeah, my car's doing right, but I'm not. No, I don't know. Like, just the wind blows wrong, and then my nose fucking starts juicing, so.
I don't know.
Or maybe I should quit picking it, probably.
Maybe.
Well, I was fucking hungry earlier, so, you know.
When you're napping.
I had to have me a burger, you know.
Good.
Thank you.
He's gonna look at him. He wants to pull it under the tent.
Oh fuck. Messy.
Yeah, so it's like 4:50 or so in the afternoon. You can see the hell it's coming down.
Not bad.
That's not bad. Yeah, we got pretty much everything all loaded up. Yes. Ooh! I was like, oh shit.
Yeah, you thought you were gonna get us, Paul?
Yeah.
Should we just fuck
Paul? He's like, bring her back in, bud. You ain't gonna.
Yeah, he's afraid now.
Oh, look at this little chicken. There's a little chicken, dude. Oh, bud. Oh, come here, you little chicken. Come here. Bark. Man, this side of my car looks premium.
Get a video of me trying to get a video.
It's a pretty uneventful drift you had so far. Basically, the only thing I've really had issues with is my e-brake, which I haven't even really been able to use it, or really needed to use it, other than a few times. But I got new pads for it, and then bled it, because it was kind of all shitty, and then adjusted it, and did a bunch of little stuff, and bled the rest of the stuff. But yeah, there's a lot of more people are showing up now.
Dried up a little bit.
You look tired. You look like you're dead.
I worked 80 hours this week and drove home from Oklahoma last night.
Damn.
Yeah.
That sounds like shit. We got that pretty thing over there. Want to be in my movie? Or you don't know yet?
Sure.
All right. So I guess necessity breeds innovation. What's really going on here?
Some freaking ghetto Jesse engineering, I guess.
Let's see. Explain it to me.
So it's hot outside, kind of. Not really.
Almost. But, well, not yet, but it's gonna be.
Like Jay-Z's.
So what is this? Hey, what is that? Right there.
So this is a little freaking like.
And where does it go?
Spraying nozzle for like Home Depot. Just like jam this back in here. Just freaking pump.
So you just reach over, pump it up, reach over and give it a squirt. Because Jesse's got the, not the best radiator shroud type of thing, but he's got these little fans. And normally it's okay, but I think you need some ducting and stuff. But it's getting kind of hot. But he's gonna go ahead and, or they're rigging up basically a homemade water thing. So I'm actually gonna do this too.
Oh, yeah.
Not today. But I'm gonna. Right, David?
Yeah.
What are you videoing?
Oh, the process.
We're gonna have three people with the same movie.
With the same movie?
Yep, three people almost, with the same
almost
movie.
Almost the same movie, but it's gonna be like different.
Hey, where are you clipping that, David?
I'm just gonna stick it in.
Is that like a little 90?
Yeah.
Oh,
well,
bud.
It's a T, and then there's gonna be one here.
Oh, wow.
Yeah.
What we're doing there?
That's premium.
Yeah. Then I'll just spray it right on the radiator.
Nice, David.
Is it working?
Hey, is Colorado drifting dope?
We can just
Oh yeah, dude.
Oh yeah.
Little homemade t-shirts, dude.
Gotta freaking copy the Motion Auto TV thing.
Well, at least you're at least selling T-shirts. I don't even have my own shit. I can't sell T-shirts. Let's print T-shirts.
Okay.
Of mine, and then we'll actually have them like watch me print T-shirts.
Yeah.
And then we'll sell them, and then I could give you some coin, and then maybe I could get me some coin,
and then teach you how to use it. Freaking just get down.
Yeah. And then I'll just come over to your house. Oh no, we'll trade tire machine for T-shirt printer,
fun.
Huh?
That's fun.
That's dope. Look at that paint though. Yeah, my car's doing pretty good today. I only just went and did one run, but I mean, it feels really, really good. I think I might adjust the dampening in the rear a little bit. A couple of times, you know, I feel like I have a little too much grip, and so I kind of wanted to, you know, take a little bit of that out, and then I could adjust it with tire pressure. But yeah, we got this little thing, stay out of the sun, and then we could stand over here, and or not stand, we could sit and make movies. Talk shit to everybody who's walking by. There's a guy out there that has like a red camera, like the cinema cameras. I don't know where he's at, but he's out there. Somebody's making a movie. Levi's van, all that stuff. Colorado Prestige Insurance, hooking it up. Sponsoring Drew Colorado, so that's dope. And yeah, that's pretty much it. I really like this FRS. Jesse having his little cooling issues, I was thinking about mine. One of the things that having that fan thermo switch is it kind of goes in a weird spot. So basically it won't let my motor drop below like 195 or like 190, because it just stays, you know, it turns itself back off after a while, after it gets so cool, and then it basically just kind of stays there. So I wired in this switch right here, that guy. That's basically a ground, and then this goes to over here. I just tapped into the fan thermo switch wire. So basically, if I want to leave it on, I basically just bam, bam. So now the fan is always on, you know, because it's seeing that ground to trigger the relay up underneath there, which is that little guy right there. So yeah, that's pretty much my kind of rat's nest, but it's a hell of a lot prettier than it used to be. But yeah, so now I can kick on my fans and actually leave them on in line and you know, instead of it shutting off and shit. So I'm gonna put that back on and go out and do some more runs. So what's as long as you guys are on, fucking David's over here stealing my movies with his shit. He got a fancy 4K one that's like, feels like your head is gonna fall off because it's so damn big. Oh, yeah. I'm thinking one over here on the right to actually get the radiator.
No, you want to do them up high because on Jesse's, then it just drips down.
Well, should we just do one right up here and then one down there at the bottom?
Just do, how many did you go? So you have his two, you could do one right here.
Yeah, but that's on the intercooler though.
Yeah, but it's gonna still go through.
Because the fans will suck it,
Because it drops the air.
The fans will sucky sucky,
well,
huh?
You're not cooling with the water, you're dropping the air towel. Because of mist. Well, it's misting.
And it's just sucky sucky time, huh?
But don't run that through because we need some of the end.
Now it's coming out of a hole. Beautiful. We could probably just stick it right through there, that's like you did. Just fuck, boop, huh?
Jesse really didn't like
boop
that, though.
And yeah. Boop.
Or in this one.
Yeah, probably boop and boop. There we go. Well, I don't want three because then it loses too much pressure and it doesn't mist anymore. That's what Jesse's was doing.
Thank you.
Okay. Go ahead.
By
well, I was just going to zip tie it right there.
Oh, yeah, that's fine. Yeah.
Oh, dude, that'd be you.
And then I'll just be like, boop, boop.
Yeah.
How's it look?
Yeah. Now turn on your fans, bud. Actually, just start your car.
Channel.
Thank you.
Yep.
Son of a bitch. He watches my fucking movies, but he uses ad block on all my shit.
And I skip the ads on my phone too, so Trevor hates me.
I was like, that's just terrible. Don't even support a local YouTube gig. That's terrible. Alright, so this is the guy that I went up for, you know, basically our first run. In our practice, we did a practice together, and his engine started making a little bit of a ticking sound. But he thought it might stay together for, you know, a couple more runs at least. And at least attempted it, but can we show them the little window in there?
I guess they always like to go above the starter is kind of the common place. Look, it even blew out the cam sensor. Holy shit. Where is it at? Yeah, cam sensor's just laying right there. Starter bolt. You got the window mod in it, I guess. Yeah, that really sucks though. That would have been a really good run.
Oh, I know.
So, yeah, because we were both doing really good both days on the practice and stuff. So, yeah, he came all the. Where did you guys come from?
St. Joe, Missouri.
Missouri, yeah, all the way out here. Colorado from Missouri, but I guess he competes in the MDU up there too. But so the engine setup, it's basically LS1, and he just had a bunch of issues with the wiring harness and stuff. So then he just was like, "Fuck it, I'm gonna throw a carb on it and the MSD box." Yep. So that's pretty much the setup on it. But yeah, it makes pretty decent power. Sounds really good. Well, it did. And selling all that stuff. But yeah, that really sucks. But yeah, I basically just got a practice run to myself, which I needed it because I punted a cone and or not a cone, a barrel. So did you get the video of the barrel?
Yeah.
Yeah. first corner, and let's see the initiation here. Swinging out wide, and oh, he's got that first clip. Peter McDonald's on him heavy. Let's see. Oh, we've got a close race. Here we go. Coming into the Monty section here, and the red car is doing well. So is Peter. All right, this is a really close race. Hold your horses. Holy shit. Lots of smoke coming out of both of these cars. These gentlemen are doing a fine job. We've got a good match. And on to the last corner. Let's see what we got. Oh, evenly matched through the last corner. And, oh, Peter passes. Oh, and spins. It's over. I don't know what happened.
You don't have any E30 parts lying around your shop for some reason, do you?
I have an E36 radio.
This is the guy that was doing the narrating.
Oh, hello, ladies and gentlemen. I am the narrator.
He's got that E30 BMW with the BMW V8 that I was talking shit to.
The one that spins all the time and hits all the barrels.
I didn't get any of those today.
Oh, nice.
Maybe I did. I don't know.
You probably did.
Are you actually gonna finish a car now instead of like building the motherfuckers? Like, tell, like, that's all you do is build them, you don't drive them. Like, the fun part is driving them and building them.
Yeah, look at this 6'8" tall son of a bitch. Just like, look at his knees, they're like in the thing, and he had to lean his head when he's driving.
Pretty much today's drift event, or you know, this weekend drift event. Everything went really, really well. I didn't throw any belts off. You know, I mean, the car did pretty awesome all day. It sucks that, you know, the only time that I actually spun was during competition, but you know, shit happens. I ran a kind of weird line, and you know, that's just what happens in drifting. So you spin and they win and all that, but yeah, sorry I didn't get no video of any of the single guys, the singles, you know, competition guys. If any of you guys were out there, you know, sorry about that. But yeah, so I should have, you know, some decent footage of a lot of the tandem runs and stuff. That wasn't actually what it was. I think who was first? First was the Turbo S14, no, Turbo Fox Body. So that was Steve Mass. Second was Forrest Wirtz, the red SR hatch, and then the third was Nick Tomberlin. And then he is Tomberlin's right there. That
It's an S13 hatch with a 1J BBTI and the drift motion upgrade. But yeah, shit, I mean, everything went really good. Yeah, just now to drive home and unload all this shit, which is like the shittiest part of drifting.
So yeah, that's pretty much my little weekend drift event, the whole Drift Colorado round 2 bash, 2-day type of thing. So yeah, it was a lot of fun after the competition and stuff. Went out and got some decent, you know, decent driving in again, did a few more tandems, you know, played around and stuff. But yeah, car did great. I didn't have any issues with it throwing the serpentine belt anymore. Hopefully that thing fixed it. Didn't look too bad in pictures. Well, I guess, you know, most of the pictures were the other side, but you know, it actually, this kind of ugly side right here. But yeah, so basically just this week I need to go ahead and redo, or just not really redo anything. I thought about repainting the front bumper and the sides and, or the, you know, that fender and stuff, but I think I'm just going to kind of wait and actually buy some fenders for it and then redo a bunch of stuff. So it's pretty much probably just going to stay like this for the time being. This next week, this next weekend, so it's, will be June 12th is the Southwest Drift Series or the Vegas Drift ProAm, and that's actually up in Denver. So that'll be at Colorado National Speedway on Sunday, June 12th. So if you guys are local, you know, be sure to check that out. You know, come out and support your boy at the whole Pro-Am. Hopefully don't have any more issues. But, you know, I was thinking about doing the electric power steering pump, but, you know, I think this one will be good. I was watching some of my old videos of last year at CNS when I was having a bunch of issues with my LS1. And, you know, it didn't look like the initiation was super rough. You know, you kind of faint into it versus, you know, doing like a really aggressive clutch kick like I was doing in Vegas. So yeah, that should be pretty much it. I mean, the car felt absolutely amazing there at that track hit, or, you know, the Front Range Airport. That was actually the first time we've ever done a venue or done a event at that venue, so hopefully we'll be doing some more to come. These Nankings, they're kind of, you know, they seem like they do pretty decent. You know, I was getting fairly even tire wear. I have a little bit of camber. You know, I'll probably add a little bit more for just the bank at CNS. But yeah, if you guys, you know, if you guys are a new subscriber and you haven't checked out any of my older videos, I had, it was one of my really older random ones. I think it was Dick Shell to Pro-Am Hell or something was the name of that video. And that was basically the Pro-Am last year at CNS. So if you guys want to check that out, I'll go ahead and I'll put the link in the description. That was kind of, you know, one of my more random ones, but you could actually see the whole, you know, see all my driving from last year and, you know, see all the bullshit that I went through on that too. That was a really random ass movie though. There was like taking a car to scrap and, you know, doing a bunch of random stuff. And then when I got to the event, my alternator wasn't charging, so I didn't do any practice runs or anything before qualifying. So basically, my two qualifying runs were my practice runs for the day. But I think I ended up fourth, or no, I think I went out in top eight in that event. But yeah, so looking forward to getting in the car again. I mean, like I said, it felt absolutely amazing at that thing. The, you know, those BC Racing coilovers feel awesome. And but yeah, hopefully you guys liked the movie, and you know, hopefully I'll have some more content this week, maybe do a midweek, and you know, come and check it out next week at CNS.